believe now that it might be, might not be possible to get them updated resources. Mr. Roberta?
I have concern as well.
Yeah, okay.
I may have not had this in place in the fall.
All right, Mrs. Miller, Mr. Roberta is.
Were we supposed to come in before the vote instead of after the vote? I'm really confused because we're not really following the proper procedure.
Well, occasionally we have a question after the vote.
I mean, no, because before, that's why there's comments and questions and we can vote. So I mean, why we weren't having this discussion before, that would be up to you.
Well, I think people didn't know.
Can I decide the discussion?
No, you can discuss away, you're just not by.
Yes, Mrs. Clemens, you're talking about the social day supervisor and I am the social day supervisor, so I did this process. I went through this process. So if you have questions about this process, you can address that to me. What is the problem with the process exactly?
First of all, this is completely, completely out of order. Second of all, to suggest that it was the same vetting process when no one had access to the material to read it, how is it vetted if you couldn't read it, first of all? Because that was what I was told. I was told that no one could read it.
So what is it about the textbook that you are concerned?
And secondly, when I had the opportunity to read it, first of all, I liked the other text better. I think that this text is more dated and it's going to be outdated in 4 years because it's more specific and the other one was more general. But honestly, I don't have to justify.
This is a 2019 copyright.
Yeah, and it's a geography book. Look, I'm not going to get into it with you because this is not the
So let's just stop the back and forth. Mr. McGurk, if you have anything else you would like to add, and then otherwise we will move it to the curriculum committee and continue our discussion there.
Well, Mrs. Yarley, I'm just curious because 5 people have voted no for this textbook, so I'm just curious as to what is it about the textbook that you disagree with? We've already been through a committee.
Actually, we weren't.
And these concerns were not raised.
We didn't have the book.
We didn't have a committee meeting.
Okay, so now that you've read the book, what was in it that?
Okay, we will continue. And the reason I feel like, I mean, there was no indication before in the, I mean, maybe we could have had the discussion before the vote if people had given an indication that it was voting against it. You said, going forward, I would like to have the same process for all the books. That gave no indication that it was going to be voted down. So,
Dr. Shag Holt even specifically said it was part of the process. So now we're going to say it's the same process.
We can't hear.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have anything else you would like to add, Ms. Roberta? That's not.
I guess my final comment would be that I think we're in very dangerous territory here when we have 5 school board members voting no on a textbook that was approved by social studies supervisor, the director of curriculum, and the 7th grade social studies teachers. So I would have been, I'm very interested to know what is the problem with that textbook, and I think we're in a very dangerous place if we're starting to say that we can't approve certain textbooks for whatever reason it might be. This is a well-received textbook. This is a well-documented textbook. This is a brand new update, 2019. And so it's a great resource for our kids, and we are literally taking that resource away from our kids at this point.
The only thing I add to this discussion is that the board is legally obligated to approve the textbook before it's adopted. It has to carry 5 votes. So whether all of the folks in this room agree or disagree that this is the right textbook, the final authority rests with the school. Whatever textbook is going to be used is going to have to garner 5 votes. So I appreciate what the professionals are saying, but the board has final authority. It's in the school code. There aren't 5 votes, so my suggestion is that the board take this up at the next available committee meeting and go from there.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Cox. So we will discuss this, add this to our curriculum agenda, and the next curriculum meeting is scheduled for May 7th. Okay, the next committee report is facilities. Mrs. Downs.
The facilities committee met on April 11th. We have one item on the agenda.
I'll second.
All right, thank you. Moved by Mrs. Madge Clemens, seconded by Mr. Kraus. Any comments or questions on that agenda item? Okay, seeing and hearing none, all those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Motion carries 9-0. Mrs. Banis Clemens?
The next facilities committee is scheduled for May 2nd.
Okay, next committee report is finance. Dr. Yarnow.
Thank you, Mrs. Yarbrough. The Finance Committee did have a meeting on April 11th, 2018. That night we discussed the usual approval of contracts and perhaps even more importantly, the budget. We had three budget presentations by different people and a general discussion about the direction the board wanted to go in terms of finalizing the budget before the proposed preliminary budget is to be voted on May 14th, presumably. So, that's what's in the minutes. Tonight I have two agenda items. The first is to approve the approval of a request for proposal concerning the solicitor for board. And I make that as a motion.
Okay, is there a second? There's no second, then the motion doesn't go anywhere.
Thank you. I'll move on to the approval of contracts. There are contracts, as discussed on the night of April 11th, to be approved. Contracts are listed as A through H, and I make a motion that we approve those contracts as listed and discussed at that meeting.
Moved by Dr. Yarnow, seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Is that correct? Okay. Any comments or questions? Okay. Seeing and hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries 9-0.
Thank you very much. The next Finance Committee meeting will be held along with the Facilities Committee meeting on the night of May 2nd.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Yarnow. Next committee report is Mrs. Miller, the IU committee report.
Thank you. I'm going to keep this brief since I'm on the call, but I just wanted to make a couple mentions. I'd like to recognize Catherine Bollinger, an 11th grade student whose self-portrait art piece made it into the student art gallery hosted by the Buckley Center. So congratulations to Catherine. It was an awesome piece. Also, I'd like to put forth that the Run, Walk, or Roll Run 5K race to raise funds for the IU Education Foundation will be held on Saturday, so please consider joining me for that. Also, our next meeting will be held on May 14th instead of May 15th because of the primary and several of the board directors or the poll. So that will be held May 14th instead of May 15th. Thank you, Mrs. Jarvie. That's it.
Yeah. Thank you, Mrs. Miller. I don't know if you know that that's our next board meeting as well, so. Yeah, well, just, so we have a conflict with that. Yeah, well, I don't know, I'll have to talk to Dr. Hoffman about that. Yeah, well, hopefully you can work it out, hopefully, and maybe with the timing, something like that, so. All right.
Okay, thank you for bringing that question. Thank you, Mr. Garvin.
Yep, all right, the next committee report is the Upper Bucks County Technical School, Mr. Kraus.
Thank you, Mrs. Yarbrough.
I missed policy.
That's all
right. Okay, personnel. Oh, I'm sorry. I just skipped way ahead. I'm just trying to move the meeting along. So, all right. I'm sorry.
Thank you for that.
Yeah. Okay. Mrs. Cullen, personnel.
Okay. The personnel committee also did not meet, and the next personnel committee meeting is scheduled for April 30th at 6:30 in this room.
Okay. Mrs. Miller, back to you, policy.
Thank you. Our next policy meeting is scheduled for April 30th. It will review of second reading for the policies we discussed last meeting, and introduce, I think, it's two more. So thank you. So April 30th is our next meeting.
Okay, thank you. All right, now we are on to the Upper Bucks County Technical School, Mr. Kraus.
Thank you, Mrs. Yarbrough. The VOTEC JOC did meet on April 19th, which time I'd like to thank Dr. Radigan for leading the search for a new director at the three sending schools, Bakertown, Palisades, and Penridge. And we have concluded that search for a new director. Mr. Jeff Sweda was unanimously approved by the JOC. Mr. Sweda will begin transitioning with Mr. Wagenseller and is scheduled to start on July 2nd. And from state competitions, we had three first place winners that are going on to nationals in June in Indianapolis. The winners are Dylan Miller, Small Engines, Jordan Myers from Quakertown, Health Occupations,